Hello, Klaus here, and here is a quick update video to a update video, which sounds a little bit strange, to the video I did yesterday about the gyro in the Blackmagic line camera update, the 8.6 update. And that video was all about testing the gyro and how that worked with the old firmware and the new firmware. And I had a lot of questions about which of the stabilizations is the best, and also somebody who talked about that the gyro weren't that good at all and you could just forget about it, and somebody asking me to actually do a comparison where I show all of the different stabilization options in DaVinci Resolve and with the same clips as I used yesterday. So that's what I'm going to do. So first we're going to take the 24mm shot we have right here, and this is just the way it is, a bit shaggy. And here we have the shot again, and this time I'm going to go over to the inspector, and on the stabilization I'm going to change this into the perspective, which is the first one, and I'm just going to push stabilize. So let's have a look at the clip. Pretty decent job. Again, we'll do it again. This time we're going to test it out with the similarity, and I'm going to stabilize that clip. And we see that it is going to zoom in just a little bit. And here we have that. And here you can see some of the yellow effects in the corners when we are using similarity. So for the next one, we are going to go to the translation, which is right here. I'm going to stabilize that. And again, this is again zooming in a bit. And here we have the translation. I also think there is a bit of yellow effect in that shot as well. So let's take the last one, which is the camera gyro. And that is, of course, going to crop in a little bit more than the other shot. So here we go. But I'm not seeing the yellow effect, which is kind of good. So again, that was the first shot, the 24mm shot. And then let's go to the shot on my beloved Helios 44. And here we have the shot without anything. And let's start by just doing the perspective here. Okay, and that zoomed in quite a bit, so let's have a look at the shot. I think that is quite good. Next shot, we are going to try it out with the similarity. I'm going to stabilize that. Here we have the similarity. And in similarity, we have the same wobble effect in the corners as on the other shot. So let's go to the next shot here. Let's go into translation and stabilize that. Let's have a look. Again, wobbly effect in the corners, and that isn't really that good. So last thing would be to use the camera gyro. Stabilize the shot, and let's have a look. I think that's pretty good. So also want to show you, if we go to this line of clip here, I'm just going to run them through. First, I'm going to run them like the regular shot, and then we're going to have all the different stabilizations, so you can see how much they actually do. And I've taken off the zoom, so it's not going to zoom in, so you can actually see how much they are working each stabilization. So here we go. Here's just the regular shot, like that. And then we go to the perspective, and we can see how that is working. Pretty neat. Again, similarity, working a little more, but it's wobbling way more. Translation, again, a little bit of wobbly in the corners. And here we have the camera gyro, which is working a bit harder than any of them. Again, here is the close-up shot in perspective. It's working quite a bit. Here in similarity, again, it's wobbling in the corner. And in translation, it's doing the same. And here's the camera gyro. So that was a look at the different stabilization options you can use in DaVinci Resolve. I do think the camera gyro is still the best, but of course you could get away with using the perspective in some cases. So in my opinion, perspective or camera gyro are the best way to use the stabilization inside of DaVinci Resolve. And in my opinion, I would always go for the camera gyro. Just remember to shoot your footage wider than it needs to be, so it's not going to crop into your image, so it's going to ruin your composition. That's all. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.